Sup dudes, today I'm telling you guys how to grind diamonds. So yeah, how to grind diamonds in Tap Time 2 is pretty simple and pretty straightforward. It really is as easy as it's easy, you know. So one of the most obvious ways of grinding diamonds is obviously achievements. As you know, you get daily achievements and you get up to like 25, 30 diamonds daily, and there are also progressions, which is a lot of diamonds. But let's say you finish all of your progressions, obviously the daily is gonna be like, it's not gonna be enough, you know. There are choices from the daily rewards which you can actually take. So yeah, as you can see at day 8 and day 2, you can get like 25. But then again, that takes a good amount of time. Now, what if I could tell you the biggest way to get diamonds is actually through tournaments. Now, I don't know if every tournament is different or anything, but the tournament's rewards just got changed. It used to be if you're at least top 130, you can actually get diamonds, but now you actually need to be top 100. So tough luck for you guys who can't get top 100. So yeah, there are multiple ways. There are top 1, top 2, 3 to 5, 6 to 10, 11 to 20, and 21 to 40, and 41 to 60, and 61 to 100. So yeah, they also changed the rewards. You get weapon upgrades and 2 fortune weapon upgrades. Now I actually don't know how to use these yet, so I'm gonna experiment a little bit, you know, with you guys. But yeah, as you can see, I got 100 diamonds. It takes like 2 days for you to get like 48 hours to get your reward and everything, but I think it's really worth it, you know. You can get like 10 diamonds, as you can see. Boom, weapon kept. I don't understand any of that. What was that? Is that like extra things like here? I don't know. Do I get to upgrade? So yeah, so crafting. One of the things that I actually want is the lightsaber, but it takes 6. Son of a gun, what does it take? 6. So yeah, oh, I actually know why it takes 6 now. It actually increases how much crafting points you need, because I actually did it. So yeah, here, this, I don't know if the Phantom Present has anything that I'm really interested in. I really have everything, you know. So yeah, this time I didn't really get the higher point because, well, people were just really good at the moment. I don't know why. So yeah, for a reason that. So yeah, it used to be like you get perks and crafting and that crafting things. Yeah, you need to get that, and that's how I craft a lot of my legendary item. I'm just gonna upgrade my guy here. Let's see how much level does he get now. Probably level like 2000. Well, that's a new one. So yeah, probably like tomorrow or maybe the next day, then that's the tournament. And that's how you do it, you know. So let's just, I'm gonna show you guys some few war cries while I'm gonna talk. So if you want to know my loadout right here, I got the Axe of Ages. I really want a better Axe of Ages because, well, I need more, you know. 6 times all damage. I don't, this I kind of chose Cybernetic Fissure. I don't know why I chose it, but I guess I actually don't know why I chose this. I just don't think I found something that's nice, you know. I used to wear the Crimson Warrior one, but then I got the Aether Forge armor, which actually times 146 of your boss gold. Like, what? That's 100, you know, that's a lot. And I used the Wi-Fi Echoes and also the Deep Purple for classic damage. When you're playing Tap of Titans and you're joining tournaments, sometimes you need to AFK at least, just like how I do. And the truth is, your heroes, they don't do anything. As you can, like, Dex here is doing like A and S damage, but sure, he's doing a good amount of damage, that, but that's because the Warcry skill. I can actually show you now how much does he do. He does like AR. Well, people here need AS, so your clan ship damage does more. Which is why it's very important to join a clan, my opinion, if you're trying to do clan wars. I mean, tournaments and everything. As you can see, my clan is Longshots 11. You guys can join. As you can see, a lot of people get kicked because they were inactive, obviously. It's pretty easy to not get kicked for inactive. You just log in, grab your logs, and just play AFK for 5 minutes, and I think that's pretty much Gucci, you know? So yeah, as you can see, actually, that I'm just gonna take a screenshot first. Oops. For the thumbnails, you know, and yeah, it is actually very important to join a clan, in my opinion. You can also join my clan, and also, yeah, as you can see, I don't upgrade these. I think it's just a waste of money and everything. And here's my perks. Yeah, so heroes and even your tap damage, like, they don't do anything. Okay, these guys, these Titans just have so much health, it's just impossible. So clan ships are very important. The only way you can actually kill them with your heroes is if you have the Warcry. So yeah, I don't know if I actually can upgrade. Nope, I cannot upgrade. I'm pretty sure you used to get skill tree too now, but mainly it's just prestige now. It is also one of the best way in my opinion. What the hell? I don't even. Oh shoot, man! I didn't even get a single skill point. Now I need to get to stage 1000. Yeah, I'm probably gonna grind there tomorrow, you know. But of course, I have school, online school, you know, to study a bit and that. So yeah, prestiging now. The relics are very important. You know, you can see my relics. One of my favorite is the Hero's Blade. It actually helps me a lot because it multiplies your hero's damage. Every hero. And there are also like Hero Shield if you're into like gold and everything. And there's a lot of these. If you guys know any cool stuff, please let me know in the comments. Obviously, I haven't owned every single thing yet. I only unlocked like 14. There's still like, how much is that, 883 more artifacts that I haven't unlocked. Obviously, the point is to unlock every single thing and be to grind like crazy as hell. So yeah, see you guys in the next episode.